Okay, hello everyone. This is Hannah from English through Hannah. 안녕하세요. 오늘 통하는 영어 전원입니다. So today we're going to have a look at the expression. How can we say 심경이 복잡해요 in English? 심경이 복잡해요를 한번 살펴볼게요. So English, we say like, look at this lady. Like she seems happy and sad, angry at the same time, right? So when we have that kind of feelings, we say, I have mixed feelings. I have mixed feelings. So you know the meaning of mixed. Mixed means, you know, you put different things together in a one place. So you have a mixed feelings. That means you feel happy, sad, angry, or you feel kind of confused at the same time. So let's have a look at the definition for mixed feelings. So this is from actually a Cambridge dictionary. So we say, if you have mixed feelings about something, you feel both pleased and not pleased about it at the same time. So it means that you have mixed feelings about something. You are happy that about that. At the same time, you feel kind of sad. So let's see some examples here. So I had mixed feelings about leaving home. 집을 떠나는 것에 대해서 마음이 약간 복잡했어요. I was excited, but at the same time, I knew I would miss my family. Like this. Have you ever had mixed feelings about something like breaking up or leaving home, going abroad, studying abroad, anything? So you are happy because it's happening, but at the same time, you kind of feel sad because you're gonna miss something. I think I have so many experiences like that. For a second example is this. I was left with mixed feelings after reading this. I was left. 는 남겨졌어요라는 뜻이에요. Okay, so we have leave는 떠나다라는 뜻도 있고 남다라는 뜻이 있어요. So you're gonna be like, what? Wait, what? They're very different things. But how come the one word has both meanings? 자, 똑같은 단어에 두 개 굉장히 상반된 뜜이 있는데 실제로 사용해 보시면요. 아, 문맥상 다 이해가 되기 때문에 그렇게 걱정은 하지 않으셔도 돼요. So I was left. 하면 남겨졌어요. With. 뭐와 함께 남겨졌어요? Mixed feelings. 굉장히 마음이 아, 뭐야 이거? 이런 마음이 들었어요. After reading this. 그거 읽고 나서. You can say, very, very good word this. I was left mixed feelings after listening to that song. 그 노래를 듣고 나서 마음이 복잡했어요. Or I was left with mixed feelings after watching the news. 그 뉴스를 보고 나서 굉장히 심경이 복잡했어요. I was left with mixed feelings after reading about the news. Because the news said, because of COVID-19, everybody has to stay at home or something like that. So mixed feelings, 좋기도 나쁘기도 했어요. I was left with mixed feelings after breaking up with my boyfriend. 자, 남자친구 헤어지고 나서 마음이 되게 복잡했어요. 이런 표현 쓸 수 있겠죠? Okay, 그럼 오늘의 미션이에요. I have mixed feelings about. I have mixed feelings when I meet my ex-boyfriend 하실 수도 있고 또 미션으로 I was left 하면 남겨졌어요 with mixed feelings after 하고 무엇을 하고 나서 아까 했던 요거 상태죠 그걸로도 남기셔도 굉장히 좋을 것 같아요 댓글로 I was left with mixed feelings after doing something 하시면 굉장히 세련된 표현을 쓸 수 있어요. 예를 들어 우리가 어떤 뭐 스피킹 시험을 보시던지 대화를 하고 나서 무언가를 하고 나서 약간 기분이 좀 그랬어 이러실 때 I was left with mixed feelings after talking to my mom on the day. 뭐 얘기하고 나서 그런 기분이 들었어요. 이렇게도 말씀해 주실 수 있을 것 같아요. 오케이 그럼 오늘은 여기까지 하늘을 통하는 영어 했습니다. 다음 시간에 볼게요.